Good morning, everyone, and welcome back to Stardew Valley and to Fuzzy Ferret Farm. Ding! I was a little bit behind myself there with the introduction. I'm going to put it down to getting used to my new house. I've finally moved in. Not here, of course. I've been here for quite some time. But I've moved into my real house, my real new house. And it is very, very good to finally be somewhere where I'm no longer having to basically live amongst boxes. Though that being said, I am currently surrounded by boxes. But they're Christmas present boxes, so it's okay. Right, let's check on what's on the television. Fortune teller. The spirits are very happy today. They will do their best to shower everyone with good fortune. What an auspicious day this is. We best not waste it. And what about the weather report? It looks like a storm is approaching. Thunder and lightning is expected. Ooh, that's kind of good because I would like to charge up the batteries a little bit. Now, yes, we are going to pop the question today. Let's go ahead and chop that. Well, it's not really popping the question. Not that question. It's more, we happen to be traveling along the same paths in life. Would you like to walk together? Sort of thing. Later on, the question gets asked. But not right now. Where's my dog? Why is my doggo not here? Leafin, it's raining. Don't make me have to hunt around for you. I won't feel right unless I've given you a pat on the head. Damn it, Leafin, where are you? Also, thank you very much for letting me know about that. I was being quite the derp. Quite the derp. Also, you can come with. Anything else I want to take out of here? Yeah, I'll take out the sweet peas as well. I can give those to Jazz if I should see her. Oh, actually, let me drop that off as well. Everything else, fairly happy with that. Now, it is snowing right now. And I'm actually fairly happy with this. No? Because it's been kind of trying to decide whether it wanted to snow for the last several days. And it's been seesawing back and forth. But finally, it made up its mind, and it's snowing. I'm extremely, extremely happy. Bodadar Paub. Come on then. Let's say hello to everyone properly. There we go. I'm going to need to drop off some eggs. Let me grab these ones out of here. And load up the mail machines right now, shall we? I think we should. Of course, we're going to keep this egg because we don't want to get rid of those ones. We can put them in the refrigerator, and that's fine. I think I'll put the void egg in here, then. Right, I have no idea who I've said hello to now. I got distracted midway. That was very silly of me. Hello, Lisa. No, I don't want to feed you a spicy... I'm sure you wouldn't mind a spicy meal, but I don't want to feed you one. Just in case. I have no idea how robust a chicken's digestive system is and how it would deal with spicy peppers. I can only imagine it would be messy. And that's just not something I want to deal with. I'll be perfectly honest with you. Not on my list of things I super want to do today. There we go. Right. Agro, would you mind taking me down here so that we can say hello to the cows? Okay, you can just pop me there. Thank you. Right, we're going to start on this side today, and there's a very specific reason for that. First and foremost, I really don't need to worry about the order in which I pick up the milks this time, because I've got enough left over that I can just go ahead and load all of these up. But the second thing is, someone has pointed out something very, very important about the way the animals work. Now, you cannot get any animals until you've got an upgraded barn of the right level for that animal. This has always been the case. However, it isn't that you need that barn for that animal to live in. You just need to have gotten to that barn level to be afforded the opportunity to buy those animals. So what we're going to do is we are going to move all of our cows over into the one barn and then have goats in this one. And I think that's a fantastic way of doing it. Thank you very much to those, I think there was three people who pointed that out based on the things I've been saying in the last couple of episodes. And it's a really, really good tip, that one. Let's go ahead. Get that done. Thank you. And pop that in there. Right, let's grab, boink, all of these. There we are. Perfect. Actually, no. No, it's not perfect. I just said I was going to have you move, and then I didn't move you. Because I'm a derp. Right, there we are. Please choose a barn for your cow. Why can't you say the name? You know the name, surely. This cow has a name. Damn you. And it's not Robert Pelson. Hopefully it never becomes Robert Pelson. Come on then, Dandelion. Let's move you over. And finally, your sister, Loddin. I really like that name. I like all of the names of our livestock, but Loddin is especially nice. Right, there we go. I think that's good. Yes, it is. Right, aggro. Would you take me... Well, I should pop into the greenhouse. I'm fairly certain, though, that there's nothing to harvest today. I'm going to go out on a limb and say there is nothing to harvest today. I'm pretty certain of this. We're going to sell... Oh, I should have left those back there. Damn. Get rid of that. We'll drop off this milk, these milks, these eggs. We got a, and these cheeses, actually. We've got a couple of things that we can do right now. So let's go about doing that. Is there anything I really wanted to drop off in there? Yes, the wood. There we go. Now then. Let's go ahead, drop off the milk, the eggs, and the cheese. Fantastic, because we were actually fairly low on milk. Wow. Okay, I'm going to have to bear that in mind. We'll eventually have to move up to Silver Star, because the majority of the milks that we get will be Silver Star milks. But for now, we seem to be doing okay. And here... we're doing all right in there as well. Okay. Aggro. Go on then. Let's check on the greenhouse. I'm fairly certain there's nothing to harvest, though. Nope. Nothing to harvest. I should trust myself in the future, it seems. Right. Let's go and talk with Marnie. I would really like to get some goats. This. We've got loads of... lovely grassy areas now as well. Right. Is Jazz going to be in? Yes. Jazz, I got a sweet pea for you. I love presents, thank you. You're welcome, Jazz. And Marnie, a daffodil. Thank you, this looks nice. My nephew Shane has been staying at my place the last few months. I know. Right. I would like to purchase some animals. This is going to be expensive. 4,000. Happy adults provide goat milk every other day. A milk pail is required to harvest the milk. Lives in the barn. Very well. Let us get our goats living in a barn. Cook. No. This goat shall be known as Maria. Maria. There we are. Great, I'll send little Maria to her new home right away. Wipe your feet! Are you talking to the goat? We want another goat. And this goat will also live in here. Rinano. It's almost close to Rhiannon. This one shall be Dylan. There we go, Dylan. Great, I'll send little Dylan to her new home right away. And finally... Yeah, we're going to blow all our money on this. We are going to get... There we go. Disarcade. There we are. Fantastic. We have got goats, Jazz. You can play with my dolls if you want to. Just make sure you brush their hair when you're done. I will. If I play with your dolls... Their hair will be gleaming. I will get tips from Elliot on how to brush long hair. There we go. That makes it sound like I never brushed my hair. Oh my lord. I am hugely embarrassed about something that I didn't even do. Right. Rather, something that I did do. Something that... you know what I mean. Hush. Right, we've got some wild horseradishes, but... There's a very specific sequence of events that we now must take part in. And we must do it quickly. This is a matter of the heart. And thus, it is hugely important. And also, it is a matter of friendship. Of sensitivity. You can probably guess, already, from this, what is about to occur. Oh. That is not what I would have guessed was about to occur. Stop telling me how to live my life. Hey, cut it out. We're letting you live here for free of charge until you finish school. Seems like you don't appreciate that at all. Harsh words. Stop trying to make me feel guilty. I appreciate that you and Dad are helping me out, but expecting me to dress the way you want is ridiculous. I'm kind of on Abigail's side here, like, fully. Not even remotely considering the other option. It's like, well, no, that's not true. I am considering the other option. It's just, in my opinion, it is completely wrong. I'm not a little girl anymore. You can't be kind to someone and then expect them to do stuff for you, because then you're not being kind, you're trading. All right, I'm sorry. Oh, well done, Caroline. Seriously? Someone there? Run away! Because I'm a coward and I like to sneak on people and listen to their private family discussions. I swear I'm such a creeper. Why is my character such a creeper? I swear this house is haunted. Why am I... My character is so bad! Why? Why did it end up like this? My garden is happy today. I am glad. And I know you know that I was there. Look, thank you for not telling on me, your daughter. Wait, that sounds so... just thanks. Oh, goodness, are you sure? Yes. Yes, I am. This is payment. Don't act like I'm doing this out of the goodness of my heart. I mean, I probably would have. But, you know that I'm basically bribing you. I seriously love this. You're the best, Aavak. That's fine. I heard your house is haunted, and I felt somehow responsible, so I wanted to give you a gift. Valley looks more interesting in the rain, don't you think? I do. You've got such a beautiful, poetic heart. Pierre. Isashimi. Very kind of you. I like this. Why are you giving my family presents? Aavak, it's most suspicious. What have you done? Well... It's more what I'm not going to do, actually. And I realized that was incredibly cruel. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Team Abigail. I am sorry. But the sensitivity that I was referring to is actually... I was actually hoping Haley wouldn't be here, but of course it's raining. Never rains a Calico Desert. That's where my friend Sandy lives. I wish I could have visited her today. Oh, I'm sorry, Emily. Haley, I wonder if there are any nice shells washed up on the beach this morning. Probably, actually. This isn't the best time of the year for shells, though. I'm sure I can find you some shells, but, yeah, you know what? This is your house. I can't ask you to go to your room. Emily, you welcomed me into this town in such a wonderful way, like, right from the beginning. And you made me feel at home, and I've developed feelings for you, and I'm rambling because I'm nervous, so just, you want to get more serious? I feel the same way. I am very thankful for this. I'm kind of nervous, aren't you? I am, but I'm very glad that I was able to speak with you here in this private setting, rather than the saloon, which was the other option. I mean, I could have at least... tried to wait for Clint not to be there, which is what I would have done if it had to be the saloon. But yeah, it's a small town. Word travels very fast. Word is going to travel very fast anyway, no matter what I do. But, I mean, as much as I feel that Clint is the orchestrator of his own misery in this regard, there's just... giving her a bouquet in front of him, it is just... that's not... conductive to anything. That isn't teaching him to be more bold about the things that he desires. That's just being a dick. There's no softer way of putting that. This is an amazing gift for my people. It is a great honor to receive something like this. You're welcome, Krobus. I've been giving gifts to a lot of people today. It seems the day of gift giving. It's because everyone is happy. Now, I'm fairly certain that luck has no part to play in the amount of relationship you develop with someone as a result of giving a gift, but somehow it felt right. Aggro. Oh. Hey, Sebastian. Aavak? Hey, I'm surprised to find you out here in the rain. Oh, I like the rain. Look at those dark clouds looming over the horizon. Oh, Sebastian, don't make me... Please don't. Maybe I should have come to the beach first. I hope they come this way. I like this weather because it makes everyone disappear, you know? Being around people makes me feel anxious. I hope that that's good for me. I mean, I guess it might. I don't feel that way around you, though. Thank you, Sebastian. We're getting soaked. Yes, we are. That's cute. Here, there's room for two. Damn it, Sebastian. I hadn't seen that event in the first game, in the first series. Sebastian, why did you do that? This is like that comic. You go around, you make your decision, you're happy with your decision. You're like, yeah, this is what romance is. This is the right thing to do. And then all of a sudden, something happens and... yeah. Why does fate do this? Why does fate make every decision hard? No, I refuse to regret my decision. There's nothing to regret about my decision. My decision was wonderful. It's just... monogamy is annoying. That's all I have to say. Agro, let's go to Haley. I want to give Haley a shell. Do I actually have a shell? I got a muscle. Coral isn't really a shell. You know what I can do? I can give Leah some driftwood. This is a really nice gift. Thank you. You're welcome, Leah. You know what? The rain makes this work worse because it is in very romantic in that setting. As he was saying, rain makes people disappear. The first thought that went through my head was that, yeah, it's why I like fishing in the rain. Because people don't really think about anything. You know, they see you fishing in the rain, they might just have a thought of you're a particularly dedicated fisherman, but they don't really bother you. They just move on. Whereas if you just stood in the rain because you just happen to like the rain, as I do, and they sometimes odd glances get cast your way. Right, let's go and sell some of the items we've got here. We've got... we're going to keep the wild horse right. We will sell those, though. And the muscle as well. I should really find Lewis. Lewis would like this pepper, I think. Right. Let's hop into the barn and... sorry, Agro. And see if we can get a couple more things in here. Yes, we can. Or we should be able to... Wonderful. Four more cheeses that we can use to make pepper poppers. And on that note, sure. I would like to eat a pepper popper right now. As it happens. There we go. Right. Shall we get the saloon today? I think we should. I think we should. And there's two things that I want to do in the saloon today. Two very important things, in my opinion. Also, I'm now going to need to carry lots of gems around. How many gifts have I given Emily today? Only one. Good. Let's go. There we are. And we're going to head to the saloon. I'm going to buy Pam a drink. Oh, I should have grabbed some strawberries for Demetrius in case I see him. Actually, it's Tuesday. I'm not going to see Demetrius in the saloon today. Oh, hey, Penny. Actually, there you go. Thank you. I really love this. You're welcome. I haven't given you a gift in ages. Hello, everyone. I need a little warm-me-up to be ready for another cold night on the ocean. Right, I need a beer. Actually, let me just double-check something. Ow! Poop. Never mind, this doesn't get in the way of the other thing I wanted to do. Lewis, hello. Good evening, Aavak. It's good to see you relaxing in the saloon. It's good for you to take a break every now and then. Your grandfather always worked himself too hard. I'll have an extra beer in his honor. You know what? I think these beers are bad for you, Lewis, because you forget you've said exactly the same thing like 5 times, 6, 20, maybe even 45 times by now. Your mind's going, Lewis. It's going to be a sad day when it happens. Let's have the winter festivals. Actually, no, it's spring. Let's not do that. Buttercup Melody. Let's go for that one. Yes, I like this one. Hey, Gus. Hi, please relax and enjoy yourself. Did Emily mention anything to you coming into work? Does she seem particularly happy? I need to know. Did she have a spring in her step? A rosy flush to her cheeks? Please relax and enjoy... Gus! Yeah, you suck. Supposed to be on my side. Well, actually, Gus is on everyone's side, and thereby Gus is on no one's side in particular. And I suppose, of the two of us, he's known Emily significantly longer. Okay, fair enough. I accept your loyalty. It's a good characteristic. Here you go, Harvey. It's for me. This is my favorite stuff. It's like you read my mind. Or I told you that it's my favorite stuff before. One or the other. Read anything interesting in the library lately? No, actually, I haven't read anything in the library lately. Hey, Sebastian. If you're lucky, you might see a frog in this weather. Yeah. Thank you for sharing your umbrella earlier. My lord. Alright, it's 7:50. Right, I'm gonna hang around in the saloon for a little bit. I'm just gonna try and... I really wish I could sit down. That would have been so good. But yeah, I'm totally just normally spending time in here. Hey, Clint. Just out of nowhere, I would like to give you a beer. This is a fun gift, thanks. I am glad that you're having fun. If you want me to upgrade the tools, you'll have to give me the correct ore. And you'll have to pay me a fee, of course. Which will now be double for you. Shh, it's okay. The news hasn't gone to him yet. It's fine. The fee is probably not double yet. So what I need to do is I need to get everything up to gold and maybe one or two iridium things before he finds out. Well, that's a little bit unfair. I'm fairly certain that he would remain professional. He wouldn't suddenly charge me more. In fact, the sad thing is Clint would probably be... I don't know. I wouldn't say he would be happy for me, but he would just be like, oh, it's probably for the best. Well, that kind of breaks my heart a little bit. God, let's go. Aggro, today is day of mixed emotions. I'm happy and I'm sad. Honestly, it's kind of a nice feeling. But at the same time, I wish it was just happy. Right, let's drop these off. I think we've more or less got everything we want. Yes. Would you take me down to the barn so that I can say hello to our baby goats? Hello, girls. Dylan is trying to sleep. So is Maria. This arcade, though. Rebel. Staying up. Well done. I approve. Keep this up. Right. Okay, well, I've got a couple of things that I can drop off now. I'm going to grab another gem or two and just keep a few gems on me at all times. Ruby. Well, actually, Ruby is considered... they're all considered minerals. That's the thing. I can't tell what the game considers an actual gem because it calls them all minerals. That is a precious gem. Right. Well, okay. I suppose we're going to turn in for the night then. It's going to be a bit of an early night. Well, for me, you know. Actually. Have I got everything okay in here? My check. Yeah, let me get these on the go first. While I'm here. And we'll go ahead and get those going. I did also notice that we've got some honey to collect. Fantastic. And this will be lovely honey too. There we go. And since I'm around this side, I may as well grab these. No, I want to get the other one. There we are. Time for us to turn in for the night. I'm going to put all of the gems down here so that I don't accidentally sell one of them. There we are. Right, we should actually turn a tidy profit today. I think we're going to do okay for ourselves. So first, the blue jazz honey. Then all the mayos. Then half of the sweet peas, I think. Actually, no. Don't sell the sweet peas. There's no reason to. Okay, with that, we are going to turn in. It has been a busy, emotionally turbulent day. To be honest, if life was easy, then it would be less fun. It's those moments where you're given pause to think and to really ache for what you want and to try and decide whether this is the thing you want the most or this is the thing that you want the most. And it's that tumult of emotions that gives life meaning, in my opinion. If it was all just humdrum, you knew exactly what you wanted all the time, it would go by too fast. You might miss so many beautiful details. All right, let's see what we get. 7,000 from farming. Not bad at all. Beautiful, large, iridium-quality milks. Lots of mayonnaise. And that's a decent amount from the Blue Jazz Honey, actually. Very nice indeed. 7,784 gold. It is now the 10th of spring. Very well. Put a dye leaf in. Don't mean to wake you, really. Ooh. We have got some things over here. We're going to have 2 melon wines, I think. Apricot wine, 2 apricot wines. Melons. Melons all the way. All right, let's check the television, shall we? Ooh, Queen of Swords rerun. Let's see if it's a real rerun. It's pumpkin pie. In my house, it's a tradition to eat pumpkin pie during the Feast of the Winter Star. The season just isn't complete without that wonderful flavor you can only achieve with the finest farm fresh pumpkins. A little nutmeg, some cinnamon, and a clove will sweep you off your feet to a land of crimson and gold. You have such a way with words. Right, let's see the fortune teller. Spirits are in good humor today. I think you'll have a little extra luck. Oh, that's nice. And the weather report. It's got to be a beautiful sunny day. Okay, that's pretty good as well. Let's go ahead and let's make some. Oh, actually, no, that is what I wanted. Some grape and jelly. There we go. This should be lovely. Okay, we've got a letter. Let's have a look at this. Hello, friend. The mountain lake has been kind to me lately. I'd like to share my good fortune with you. Linus. Thank you very much, Linus. Always looking out for me. There we are. Let's drop those off. And I think we're good. Let me just check on the trees. Everything looks okay. We've got a little bit of something there that I need to collect. But otherwise, all is well. Ooh, we've got loads of strawberries to collect. And some parsnips to collect as well. Today is good. Aggro, today is good. But we'll collect those last. Oh, of course. Leafing didn't come out yesterday, so that's all fine. Right, let's head in. Oh, I've got to be honest. It's a little bit creepy hearing the house make noises around me at the moment. I'm too used to recording when I'm on my own. There we go. There we are. Hello, hello, hello. Hope you all had a wonderful sleep and that I didn't interrupt you when I came in fairly late at night to set up the main machines. Sorry if I did. We are going to make a fairly good bit of cash today. My lord. This many duck eggs. Yes. We'll drop these off as well. We'll possibly put those through the meal machines later. Shall we go and check on the bats today, Aggro? They've got a little project. We'll let them keep it for now. Right. Whisk me off. I wish to say hello to the goats, and then I wish to say hello to the cows. Then we will deal with the farm itself. Do I have any grapes on me? Yes, I do. Good, because I'm fairly certain it is in fact Vincent's birthday today. Now, there is nothing else we can do with the goats for a little while. So, we can just chill out there. Hello, my lovelies. How was your sleep? I hope you all got on really well. I know you're not all used to each other yet, but I trust that you'll all be firm friends. And think of it this way. With more of you in the barn's going to be warmer at night. Eh? It's like an unintended benefit, but it is a benefit that you should be aware of. Okay, my inventory's starting to get full. Alright. Let's see what we can do. Hopefully we can get it. I love it when they poke their tongues out. Makes me unreasonably happy. Got a decent bit of iridium so far. Oops. There we go. I'm not entirely sure. Oh, there we are. I wasn't entirely sure that I had milked everyone yet. There we go. Very nice indeed. And there. We have 3 already unlocks today. That's pretty awesome, if you ask me. Okay. Well, that... Okay. Sorry, Bodin. I wasn't trying to feed you milk. I know you're grown up. You don't need milk anymore. You need grass. Lots and lots of delicious grass. But failing that, you will accept hay. Because you're not unreasonable. Let's do that. Now, I wouldn't mind... The day like today, where it's all rainy, going and seeing if we can't get a legendary fish. Now, I was getting them completely mixed up previously, and again, I'm so sorry for that. What a derp. But thank you for everyone who corrected me and pointed out that I was getting the fall and the spring legendary fishes mixed up badly. You. One wood. I'll drop that off. There we go. Okay, hopefully... Many lightning rods will actually start to charge with all of it. There we go. Right, it is time for us to leave. Marnie and Linus, they're at full hearts. Lewis, I can't give anything to. Demetrius, I can. And since I'm going to be going up that way, I probably should. Sure, okay, let's see if... Oh, well, I know I'm going to be able to. There's loads of... strawberries around, so let me just go and grab all of these while I've got a farming buff. Glorious. Alright, I'm going to just grab all of these. Should be able to do it fairly quickly. We'll also have all the parsnips as well. Would be particularly nice, but I'm going to have to decide what I'm going to plant in the place of the parsnips. Now, it's Wednesday, so I can't just go and get extra seeds from the store, which... is somewhat ungood. Dissatisfying is the word I was really looking for, but ungood is the only one that came to mind. Don't ask. It'll embarrass me. Just roll with it. Alright, we'll go ahead and we'll get some more potato seeds. I could use some of these to get some more parsnip seeds, actually. Sure. It's going to be a good day. We're going to make a lot of money today, I think. There's the potato seeds. 3 potato seeds. Fantastic. We're starting to build up a crop. There we go. I'm going to drop the rest off in here. And the parsnip seeds we got. Oh, we got a reasonable amount. Let's get all these 3. Only the low-quality ones. I'll keep some of the high-quality ones, actually. In fact, I'll keep all of the high-quality ones because we can use parsnips to make certain foods. And that would actually be pretty cool. So I'm just going to wait for a few moments while they produce seeds. And then we'll move from there. There we go. We've not got a bad amount of parsnip seeds, actually. Not a bad amount at all. Where's Agro's over here? There we go. Let's just get these all planted. And 1, 2. Sure, we'll just get this one across there. I'm not going to bother with the fertilizer. Don't really need it. There we are. Wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. We've also got a spare torch. Right, let's drop off. Pretty much all the blueberries are going to be dropped off. All of those. No, we're going to keep all of the gold ones. Those are the ones we'll keep for presents, I think. We'll drop these off as well. Right. Going good today. Going very good. We want to drop off all of the parsnips. And I am going to grab the trap bobber. And dressed spinner. So I'm eventually going to want to switch to the dressed spinner. Now then, I think we're about ready to head out. So let's go. There we go. And we're going to go and visit Emily. Make sure that she's happy. Have a bit of a chat with her. Maybe there'll be some different dialogue. I don't know how much the dialogue changes when you're dating someone as opposed to when you cross a heart threshold. Hi, Emily. Hi, Aavak. I always knew we'd become close like this. Oh, that's so sweet. Here, a ruby. This gift is fabulous. Thank you so much. You're more than welcome. Wish I had a sunflower. Haley. I spent all morning doing my hair. Now the rain could mess it up. Life is hard sometimes. Well, to be fair, the forecast did say it was going to be a storm. You've got a television, or at least you've got a computer. Might be worth checking that out in the future, before spending hours and hours doing your hair. Right, we... Wait. What am I doing? I'm being a derp. Being a massive derp. Is it indeed Vincent's birthday today? No, don't eat the grape. It is. Haha! I'm not a terrible person. I do remember people's birthdays. Sometimes. Most of the time. Sometimes. Ooh. Hello? This is a very cutscene-heavy episode today. Oh, hi, Aavak. I was just about to have a snack. Here, let me get something for you. No! Wasted eggs. I hope that wasn't from one of my chickens. Oh no, what a mess. What was that sound? This is absolutely terrible. What happened? It's just an egg. It could just be cleaned up. I'll bring you more. Tell her, Aavak. Sam dropped the snack as he was handing it to me. Sam handed me the snack, and then I dropped it. Sam dropped it on purpose. He thought it would be fun. Ah, there are sometimes when Dark Aavak comes out that is like, oh, I just want to know how this would play out. But no, I totally dropped it. Yeah, that's what happened. Thanks for telling me the truth, Aavak. It's not such a big deal. I'm glad. I'm glad you think that. I'm sorry about this, Mum. I'll clean it up. Thanks, honey. All's well that ends well. Here you go, Vincent. Happy birthday, young man. Birthday gift? That's very kind of you. I love it. You're welcome. Sorry about what happened earlier. That's okay. You've been here a while now, haven't you? Your farm must be thriving. It's not doing too bad. No, that was a gift. You like a pumpkin? Hey now, this is a really great gift. Thanks. Oh, you're more than welcome. I wasn't expecting that to be as light as it did. Did you wipe your boots off before coming in? Sorry, I just cleaned the floor. That's all. That's perfectly fine. I know not to give you that. It hurts my soul that you don't like them, but... Thank you. This makes my day really special. You're more than welcome. Have fun with Vincent on his birthday. No doubt you have many, many activities planned. Right. My good deed for the day done. Let us be off. Actually... Evelyn? Hello? Oh, Aavak, you're wondering what that good smell is? Why, that's nice of you to say. I'm actually baking my famous cookies. What makes them famous? They've been featured in some television show or written about in some book? Has their poetry been written about them? A saga, perhaps? Where they were responsible for giving the hero that last ounce of strength he needed to defeat the... I'm overthinking this, clearly. Here, why don't you try one? I still think my version is better, though. Rather than just being, oh, everyone likes them. This actually saved the world. Well, what do you think? It's delicious. It was nothing at all like chewing on a hockey puck. Thank you. I think we've come to know each other well enough for me to give you my recipe. Just make sure to keep it a secret, though. I can now make my own special Evelyn brand famous cookies. Ah, this is marvelous. The legend lives on. I will pass this recipe down to my children. They will pass it to their children. So on and so forth. The legacy shall be continued. It's awful cold, isn't it? What a rotten day. Would you like a leak? This is my favorite thing. Thank you. You're more than welcome. I saw the most beautiful family of butterflies sunning themselves in the town garden yesterday. Really? It was pouring down with rain yesterday. Here you go, Evelyn. Oh my, this looks wonderful. That's very kind of you. You're more than welcome, Evelyn. I'm not sure she actually saw the butterflies, though. I think her eyesight may have been playing tricks on her. If she did see a bunch of butterflies sunning themselves, they were committing ritual family suicide. Which does change that beautiful, thought into something a little bit less. Well, actually, somehow not less beautiful. There's something to be said. Perhaps they were restoring their family's honor. I really love this. How did you know? Well, it may have something to do with the fact that I've given you the same thing about for 2 weeks now, and you've said that you really like it. You and Sam are probably my only friends in this town. Oh, Sebastian. I'm sorry. What about Abigail, though? I'm sure Abigail is friends with you. She drops by, you know. Here we go, Demetrius. I found you. You're giving this to me? This is amazing. I know. Also, Maru. Is that... Oh, wow. This is spectacular. You're more than welcome. I am happy that everyone else is happy. Here you go, Robin. A daffodil. Thank you. This might come in handy. Really? Hey there, Aavak. I was just daydreaming about some new carpentry project. Do you have any awesome furniture that doesn't cost too terribly much? You do. Yes, and yes. Fairly certain that if I go back in, I can buy it. Yes, aha, fantastic. Thank you very much, Robin. Right, we need to try and get ourselves... I think it's the log that we've got to fish at to have a chance of getting the legendary fish. We're not entirely certain, though. We could be wrong about that. I'm not sure if the best chance of getting to that log is from the little island or from over here. No, it'll be the little island, I guess. I'm not sure that I'm going to have the range on my cast to get that. Maybe I'll have to come back up here with perhaps something like... no, wait. It's not the mountain lake, is it? No. It's in the Snap Forest. I'm a derp. I'm a massive, epic derp. I think. I might not be. Oh, damn it. I'm confused. Okay, we're going to go to Snap Forest. Because I'm fairly certain there's no way that I can cast out to that log, but I'm certain that I caught the springfish under a log. There's only one log that I can... Well, there's two logs that I can think of that I can reach with my cast. And my cast is pretty bloody good. You know, hashtag casual boast. I'm really good at fishing. I think I will try this in the Snap one. I may fail. It may be terrible. But we're going to give it an honest try and see if we can't get ourselves a legendary fish. Go and have a look at this then. See, this is the log that I'm thinking about. Right, we've got the trap bobber, don't we? Yes. Let's put the bass bait in there. Now, I don't know if I can actually cast it in a storm. Catch it in a storm, rather. But we'll see. There we go. Legendary fish? No. That is a shame. But it is okay. I forgive you. There we are. We've got a smallmouth bass. Oh. Miscast. Another smallmouth bass by the looks of it. Apparently that was a particularly good smallmouth bass. And some algae. And more algae to go with our smallmouth bass. We can wrap it up. Roast it over an open fire. It'll be grand. More algae. We can have a bed of algae upon which we will lay our roasted smallmouth bass. Garnished with strawberries. Oh, don't give me an odd look, okay? I play Dwarf Fortress. You can make food out of anything. Okay. I think this fish has just given up. Yep. It just gave up. I was like, there's no point. You're going to catch me. My mother told me never to go for dangling worms in the pond. If it seemed too good to be true, it was too good to be true. You might be caught by the demon, the fish-slaying monster, Aavak. And here I am, caught. I'll just give up. It's going to be over quicker that way. Okay, I'm not at all catching any fish. Maybe it is the mountain lake that I need to go to then. Well, Dragon Blast. I may have to go back to my first series and actually have a look around. See how many... see which episode I got the Spring Legendary fish in and work out where that was. Usually not this bad at remembering details, though. I'm going to say that all the excitement of moving house has pushed out other important information from my brain. It only had a certain amount of room, and it's all been used up now. But okay, we're not going to get any more. So let's head home. Let's head home, Aavak. That's enough for now. Actually, you go and grab some hardwood. It's not that late. Let's go and do that, since we're out anyway. We might as well. And it'll be a good, nice way to end the episode. With a little bit of hardwood gathering, because we're going to need some for our house, which we are most definitely going to be upgrading. Okay, our inventory is starting to fill up. There we go. Some common mushrooms. Reasonable amount of common mushrooms. I really should pick as many mushrooms as I can. Damn it, I've got no more room. The seeds can go, so we can play. There we go. But I really do need to gather as many mushrooms as I can. Otherwise, I will possibly find a recipe that I can't make later in the year. Because you only get them, I think, in spring, and I don't think you can in summer. If you do, they're reduced, because I think there's an expanded amount of things that can spawn in summer. So the likelihood of an other mushroom spawning is just going to be lower as a result. Sorry, I had to get rid of you, otherwise you would have gone in my way. Now hopefully we are going to have a huge amount of batteries that we're going to be able to use to make lots of iridium sprinklers in the future. Autumn is the best time for storms, though, because they're so common in autumn. But the other seasons, you'll occasionally get them. There we go. Right, time to turn in. We've got an inventory absolutely chock-a-block full of good stuff. There we are. I need to have some light further down, though. I'll probably have to set that up in the very near future. There we go. Let's drop these off. Mushrooms. Lots of mushrooms. Let's grab the wild horseradish, though. We'll bring that with. And we'll go pop the fish that we caught in there. We'll keep the algae. And I guess we'll get rid of quite a lot of the mushrooms. Why am I calling everything mushroom? We'll get rid of quite a lot of the strawberries as well, actually. Now, before we turn in, the last thing I'm going to do tonight, I'm going to go and check on all of the cattle, just to make sure that I have actually fed them all. Yep. Also, we've got a little bit of cheese that we can get. There we go. Two to sell, two to keep. And we'll call in on the chickens as well. Yep. Now, we have got enough money that I can happily go ahead and get the last goat that we need. And I will almost certainly do that tomorrow. Hello. There we are. I must confess, I totally didn't even check if I... fed the goats. Damn it! I think I fed the goats, though. I went down there to check, and then I forgot to check. Yep. Good old reliable Aavak. But we should make a fair bit of money tonight, actually. All things said and done, we've had a really good past couple of days. It didn't need to be like this, but... Okay, well, if you're going to run away, I'm completely okay with letting you run away. Right, we need these end tables placed down. Now, I'm fairly certain if I put it up there, I'm not going to be able to pass by, which always seems to be the case. Those down. It's not great, is it? We'll improve it in time. But the house plant, now this... Sure, we'll pop one there. Maybe we'll pop that one over here. Something like that. Okay. I'm fairly happy with where all of this has gone. It's 1:40. We shouldn't still be up. We can now place you down on one of these. You can go there. And I'm going to go to sleep. Good night, everyone! Not bad. Wow, we really did make quite a lot of money there. 16 Silver Star Strawberries got us 2,400. The 4 Duck Mayonnaise, 1,800. Yeah, not bad. 12,000 in one day. We weren't even really trying. But on that note, we are going to be wrapping today's episode up. I do hope you've enjoyed this episode and will be joining me for the next. As ever, remember to like if you liked, sub if you haven't, and I'll see you next time. Take care, everyone.